In this storyline mini masterclass, we're going to take a look at how to use groups. And this one should be a bit shorter than our others just because groups are not the most essential feature in storyline, but they can save you a ton of time and make certain things a whole lot easier. So if you're new to groups, this should definitely help. These are the main purposes. Groups are there to keep things organized and make them easier to move around the screen. They make certain animations possible. So if you don't know how to use groups, there are some things that you just won't be able to do. And they can actually make certain alignment tasks a whole lot easier as well. I don't know how it would be possible without it other than taking a lot of time. So I'm going to show that all off here. I'll make this file available for you too if you want to play around with it. These type of layouts are really good to practice on with groups. So first up, let's look at how to actually create a group. Okay, so you see we have all these like individual objects on the slide. If we want to group them, we actually need to select all of them. And we can do that by clicking and dragging that box over everything. And then we could see on our timeline down here that all of them are selected. The other option is just like to click on the timeline, find the first one, and then hold down the shift key and scroll all the way to the top and then select the top one. And we can select everything that way too. So once we have what we want to group selected, we can just press the Control G key on our keyboard for group. And notice that changes all of those different squares to a single group on our timeline. And we can name that group just like, I can name this squares. We can name it just like we can name any other object. And again, that's Control G to create a group if you're on Windows, or Command G if you're on a Mac. The other way to do it, I'm just going to ungroup that. The other way to do it is by right-clicking, hovering over the little group option, and then selecting group. This is one of the most handy shortcuts you'll probably have, because you don't want to have to like right-click and drill into those menus every time you do this, especially because you can ungroup just as easily. So the less right-clicking and menu digging you have to do, the better. I actually have a whole like PDF that has all the keyboard shortcuts on it. So go ahead and download that with the link in the description if you haven't already. It will save you a lot of time. Okay, so let's look back into this. We're going to regroup this. We're going to press Control G to group it. You know, every time you actually like create that group over, you're going to need to rename it, but we will look at some options for that. So when you have the group, notice you have this little like caret icon to the left of it. If you click on that, you could still see everything that is within your group. So it didn't just like disappear. It's still all there. If we click out of it, we can click back in. When you first click on a group, it's going to select the group as a whole. And you can tell that because that's what, these like bounding boxes around. But if you click on something inside of the group after you've selected the group, then you can select these individual objects. So for example, if I want to like change the color of one of these squares, if I just click on the group and then change the shape fill, it's going to change it for everything in the group. So I'm going to undo that. But what you could do after you've selected the group is you can select one of these individual objects, and you can tell by, the bounding box around it and those little handles around it. Now, if we change it to black, it will only change that individual object. So just know that when working with groups, it could get confusing if you're like trying to edit things within a group, but having a hard time accessing it. You just need to click on an extra time because the first click only selects the group. And when you do have the group selected, it's really nice because you can like drag it around and it drags as a whole. You don't have to like reselect all of those things again. You can just click and drag and it will bring the whole group together. So that's really handy. Let's talk about ungrouping. Say you're like, wait, I don't need this grouped anymore. Like that was a mistake. You can do Control Shift G. So like Control G for grouping, you can do Control Shift G for ungrouping. Those are two of the most helpful keyboard shortcuts, especially if you're going to use groups for some of these features I'm going to show you next. But one more thing I want to show you, you know how to group, you know how to ungroup. You can also, say you're like, oh no, I need to make that group, but now I don't want to have to like select all 10 of those things again. Maybe they were all at like weird spots around your slide and there's other stuff you don't want in it. What you could do is you could just right click one of the objects that was in that group. You can hover over this group option and you can select regroup. Very, very helpful feature there. You click on that, it's going to put it back into the last group that it was in. So that will save you a lot of time too, because there are situations like that where, you can't just like drag it over and select everything. So that's how you group, ungroup, and regroup. Really helpful to know how to do that. And here is why it's so cool. So I'm going to group this. I'm going to, you know, say you have stuff down here and you want it to easily be centered. If it's ungrouped, watch. Say you're just like, I want, you know, this to be nicely centered on the screen. If I press this center option up here where we align it to the center, it's just going to align it to whatever centermost shape it's in. Now they're all stacked on top of each other. You see, that's not the effect we were going for. Instead, we're going to select them all, press Control G to form a group. And now if we align the group to the center, that's how we can get that nice even spacing on the left and the right. And then we can drag it up and see, now we have a nice centered group. So that is like how it's really helpful for alignment purposes, right? There's no way to really do that without that, unless you're going to be like dragging each of these individually. And like, it's just going to be really complicated. Sometimes it's easy to just be like, okay, yeah, I need these centered. Let me grab them, group them, center the group on the slide so there's equal space on the left and the right, and then ungroup them. And that's why those keyboard shortcuts are so helpful. You might group things for temporary operations. Like, you might not, you know, need to keep things grouped essentially. So very helpful for alignment. And the other piece of this is that it makes certain animations possible. So we're going to wind up doing a whole video on animations. We haven't done that yet, but I'm going to select all of these, go to the animations tab, and notice I have this fly in animation. So they're flying in from the left over 2 seconds. I want it to be nice and smooth. I want them to keep this space in between them as they fly in. Let's see how it goes. That is definitely not what we were going for. You notice that they're all overlapped like that. And I'm just going to get rid of it from the text. So the reason for this is because it's taking this square right here 2 seconds to get from off of the screen into this position. But it's also taking this square all the way over here the same amount of time, 2 seconds, to go from off of the screen to all the way over here. So this square has to move way faster than this square because it has so much more distance to travel. And that's why when we preview this, we get this effect where they're all kind of overlapping, because this one's already slowing down and stopping while this one is still speeding up, and then you have everything in between. Now what we can do is we can select all of these, we can get rid of the animation from all of them, so now they're not animated, but then we can group them, and then we can add that fly in from the left animation to the group. And now instead of treating it as all those individual squares, it's treating it as a single object. So it's gonna take this whole object to go from off the screen to this position. So it will maintain that spacing between everything. You see? Now you might be like, okay, well, why would I want to do that with a bunch of squares? What's the point? The point is because a lot of times people have like, you know, little windows like this over like a background and they want to animate them in. So check this out. If I animate this individually, I'm going to add like a fly in animation from the top, right? That's pretty common. Let's see what that looks like. It is not looking good. I'm going to preview this. You have like text. These text pieces are overlapping. The button is like overlapping with that text. It is just not the best look. We could even probably slow it down to get a better view of what's happening here. So look at how much overlap that is. That is not what we want at all. Again, it's because it's taken this, you know, this text getting here takes the same amount of time as that button getting all the way down here. So we don't want that. We're going to get rid of all of these animations. I'm going to press Control G to group this, and then we are going to fly in from the top. And this is going to be a way better effect. So now it comes in as a unit. You see, like, this whole thing moves in together. Things aren't so like disjointed and overlapping. So there we go. I use groups for that. You know, similarly, I'm going to ungroup this. You know, imagine if this was like down here and it's like, oh no, I need all of this to be centered. Again, so easy. Just select it all. And the way I'm doing that is just by clicking one of these objects and then holding down the shift or control key, either one works, and then clicking on the other options you want to add to the group and then pressing control G. And then you can just like use these alignment tools up here, align it to the center, align it to the middle, and then I could even ungroup it if I wanted at this point, because now it is perfectly centered all around. So there we have it. That is how to work with groups. Again, I didn't have any like big challenges in this one. It's not as complex of a topic, but I will link the practice file beneath the video just in case you'd like to check it out. There's definitely more videos coming in this playlist. So subscribe and like the video if you'd like to see more storyline tutorials like this in the future. Thanks for making it to the end, and I'll see you in the next one.